Although it could be argued that every tool within your entire Lean Six Sigma toolkit is designed to make some kind of decision or another, the focus of this video will be on those few tools whose primary purpose is decision making. Now, all of these decision making tools come with the Kaizen bundle. So let's start with the values list, which is a great place to start because it has this wonderful combination of being both one of the most powerful decision-making tools and one of the easiest to use. And it's available as a free trial, so you can download it and try it yourself. If we zoom in, we notice that this tool really shines when personal preferences are really important. Things like choosing a college or choosing what you're looking for in a spouse. Or if we scroll down, we notice that this is one of the most popular exercises in the book, What Color is Your Parachute, for planning your career. Notice that those are all really important big decisions where personal preferences carry a lot more weight than just cold statistics and facts. So corporate examples might be coming up with shared values or asking your customers what they like and want from you. But probably the single most popular use of this template is using it with other decision-making tools. For instance, let's say that on the decision matrix, your very enthusiastic team had come up with 58 different objectives that you were trying to accomplish. And you, as the facilitator, said, "Come on, you guys, that's ridiculous. We're not going to compare every alternative against 58 different objectives. Let's use the values list to narrow it down to our 7 or 10 or however many most important objectives. And then we'll compare the alternatives to those." So how do we use the values list? It's really easy. First, we're going to define the decision that needs to be made and summarize that here in the title at the top of the page. Let's use an example we can all relate to. And here we start entering options in a completely random sequence. Gee, I guess if I'm going to work, I should be paid for it. Let's see, what else? I'm a real outdoors person. Now, maybe animals wouldn't even show up on your list, but boy, that's important to me. I can optionally enter comments over here, and I can optionally insert link icons to related documents, like maybe that Excel spreadsheet that I created that has our family budget. So I'll make a hyperlink to that, and there you go. There's a good start to my unprioritized list. By the way, if anything you've seen is new to you or you can't find your templates, then you probably haven't watched the quick start training videos, and I highly recommend that you stop this video and do that, because once you're trained on one, you're trained on all 150 Systems to Win templates. So the next step is to scroll down to the next section, where you will notice that your title and your unprioritized lists have already been populated for you, so all that you need to do is fill in the grid with the ID number that answers the question, if I could only have one of these and not the other, which one would I choose? So for me, did I mention I love animals? I just gotta be with animals in my career. So once I've finished filling out the grid with my priorities, I simply scroll down to the next section. And there's my prioritized list. I don't edit anything in this section. It's all done for me. Now let's look at the other decision-making tools. The decision matrix is also very easy to use. Let's just use the sample data. And let's just add another alternative to the sample data that's already there. Then we just use our user-defined rating scale to enter a value, indicating how well does this alternative meet each objective. And like all Systems to Win templates, all drop-down lists are defined on the DV worksheet, where you can define any rating scale that makes the most sense for your team. Back on the sample sheet, let's select a cell containing a drop-down list. Notice that if we select a period from the drop-down list, that means that the team has discussed it and agreed that that alternative contributes nothing toward the fulfillment of that objective. And that cell remains white, as compared to if we select a positive value, that cell turns a bright color. Now, if you scroll down, you'll see this text box that tells you it's really important to keep related columns together. In order to do all that fancy math, the only way we could do it was to keep two related columns together. So that's the reason that this sheet is protected, is one of those contains a formula that we don't want you messing with. So if you want to move anything or delete anything, you're gonna or copy it, you're gonna need to unprotect the sheet first. And if you don't know how, follow our instructions and learn. What we hate about that is that means that importance and objectives above, those need to be merged cells. And we hate merged cells because they cause bugs. So now we've got to teach you about a bug. And that is that if you want to delete text within a merged cell in a protected workbook, just pressing the delete key doesn't work. Why? I don't know. It's an Excel bug. We didn't write Excel. We're just trying to teach you how to use it. The backspace key works. Or if you go up to the formula bar, you can delete it there. But the delete key doesn't work in a merged cell. When we click any row or column heading in any Systems Twin template, we see pop-up help, which tells us that the raw score is the sum of the rating times the importance. So let's go change the importance of making money. Let's say that's only worth a 5 to us, not a 9. And then notice how all those raw scores change. Notice how the adjusted scores take those raw scores and adjust them for your rating scale, which is currently a 10. So if their top alternative is a 10 out of 10, how do the others compare in relation? But notice we got two 10s. So what if we were to change our rating scale, maybe to a scale of 100? So now our adjusted scores are on a scale of 100. So the last thing that we might want to do before making our final ranking decisions might be to consider some additional factors that we can define in these user-defined fields here. For instance, if the same person is responsible for a couple different projects, maybe they only have capacity to do one. Or maybe budget is a consideration. And notice that in this field here, you can choose from a drop-down list for the desired direction of your measure. Let's see, budget, we would prefer to be lower. And you can add unlimited columns of user-defined fields, and you could add comments for any alternative, and you can add links to related documents before you finally make your final decisions regarding your team's priority ranking. Pretty slick, isn't it? But slick as that is, the most popular decision-making tool is even slicker. The Decision Pick Matrix is the most popular decision-making tool because it has pretty much everything that the Decision Matrix has, plus it has this chart that plots the impact that each alternative will have toward accomplishing the objectives compared to the effort that it'll take to accomplish each of those alternatives. So just like the Decision Matrix, let's add another alternative and select from the drop-down list that contains our user-defined rating scale that we defined on the DV sheet, and do that for each objective. And notice that it automatically calculates our raw score based upon the rating times the importance of each objective. And it automatically adjusts it to a 0 to 10 scale for impact. But notice that that new value is not going to show up on our chart until we enter the second value needed by the chart, which is the effort. So let's enter a value for effort. Let's say that that's maybe a 3. And now notice that there's a fourth point on our chart. But notice it doesn't have a label until we click the button to apply chart labels. Now the new point on the chart has a label. Now, unlike the decision matrix, on the pick matrix, the scale for both impact and effort is always a 10-point scale. What you can do, however, is change the maximum value for your highest-ranked alternative. See how all the impact values on the chart went down? And if we change it back to 90% again, they all go up. So again, you've got unlimited user fields, you've got comments, you've got links. You can take into consideration all those other factors before finally ranking your alternatives. So the Decision Pick Matrix is a variation of a quadrant chart. In the world of Lean Six Sigma, there are dozens, if not hundreds, of other types of quadrant charts. All of them seek to visually understand relationships between two factors affecting an issue. Use the much more versatile quadrant chart template to create a wide variety of problem-solving charts, as you will learn in our online training. The final decision-making template is the Prioritization Matrix. It's the most thorough of the decision-making tools. It's the right tool to use when there are serious disagreements between influential people and/or there are serious consequences for a wrong choice. Like the values list, you start with an unprioritized list. Then you scroll to the next section, where you compare each alternative to all other alternatives, but this time you select from a drop-down list to choose a rating of how much better is this alternative versus that other one. And notice that our fancy program automatically calculates the equal and opposite value in the appropriate cell. And just like the values list, you scroll down to the section containing your prioritized list. And you don't need to edit anything in that section. Everything has been done for you. So the tool itself is pretty simple to use. And like all Lean Six Sigma tools, you can use it in creative, diverse ways. But if you're going to use it in the classic way, then you're going to want to carefully follow the instructions in our online training for the analytical criteria method, where you use the first worksheet to weight your objectives, and then you create one worksheet per objective, where you compare each alternative against each objective on its own sheet. And then you put everything together in the end in a decision matrix to make your final decision. Now, most people will only use the analytical criteria method maybe once or twice in their entire life for some really big decision. Usually, you'll be choosing between these other simpler tools to find your desired balance between speedy easy and thoroughness of evaluation.